Thursday afternoon, on-demand storm tracker forecast. Still tracking some snow banding and a few squalls out there this afternoon, having a little bit of an impact, mainly on passes or those areas closest to the Montana-Idaho state line. You can see West Yellowstone, lots of snow on the ground there as well. Now, this pattern will begin to change as skies clear and colder temperatures take a foothold over the region. Upper-level low sitting over Canada. Got a fairly flat flow aloft, and that zonal flow in the jet stream is keeping temperatures near average here for today. But there is a little bit of scattering of snow showers, mainly mountain-based. And again, that can create wet roads that could become icy overnight into early tomorrow morning. But as you look in the high-resolution modeling, these little bands will taper after sunset tonight and should diminish altogether. So there could be some patchy fog tomorrow morning, but tomorrow should be a sunny day. And again, just watch for some icy roads first thing in the morning, but it looks mostly dry and a little colder as we go through the weekend. So a slight chance for some minor accumulating snow, mainly higher base. The brunt of this is going to be west of Interstate 15 this afternoon into tomorrow morning. But again, I'm not holding my breath on anything significant, but it's this nuisance type snow that can bring some tricky travel in some areas. Most of the roads are dry, and then all of a sudden you hit some icy spots. So be careful traveling out there. So again, I'll keep a slight chance for a flurry or two up until about sunset for Butte tonight, but clearing after midnight down about 10 degrees tomorrow, 34 and mostly sunny. Bozeman, yeah, a few passing showers, but again, I don't expect this to be significant, but if we do see some, those wet roads could turn icy tonight into tomorrow morning, and temperatures trying to get into the mid-30s with lots of sunshine for your Friday.